want you to be a big part of that. I don't doubt that for a second. So to me, I still think they really expect you to be with them doing that.
Yeah,
know?
For sure. I want to be here, obviously. I have a great relationship with a lot of people in the organization and on the team. I'm only the team I've ever played for is the Mets and the minors. And so it's like, it's home. I don't know what it would be like playing for other teams.
Yeah, and I think they also, it's a funny thing, they have a fear that if they disqualify you, you might wind up, pulling a Chris Davis, hitting a million home runs for somebody else.
It's very possible.
Yeah, I mean, that happened. That's life. I mean, that's baseball. I mean, look at Chris Davis. He got traded. I mean, guys come out of nowhere. And look at Young now. Young was released. He's now playing well for the Mets. I mean, you never know with baseball,
And that's the thing. This year's not my career.
Right.
Obviously, in my career, I've done way better. But it's just sometimes you go through those stretches, and hopefully, from here on, I start playing better. And
were you crazy streaky your whole life?
I always have kind of been a slow starter.
Yeah.
College and everything, I've always done better later in the season. But never this bad. The last 2 seasons, the starts have been.
Does the platooning, is that make it harder or is it make it easy just to see right-handed pitching? Does the platooning make it harder?
Sometimes just because sometimes you feel better against lefties. It's just the season. Sometimes you see lefties horribly.
Right.
Sometimes you see them.
And you're proving you can hit lefties. Look at last year.
Yeah, when there's a really, really good lefty, no one really hits.
Right. Yeah, I saw that guy last night, Chapman, throw 101. I mean, how nasty is he? I mean, have you hit against him?
I've struck out.
So has everybody else. So, I mean, he threw last night. He threw a pitch to Adam Jones. I swear Adam Jones didn't see it. I mean, he was 101, 2 straight pitches. That is crazy. Can you see the ball against him?
You can, but it's a split second.
It's a blur, right?
And to actually hit it hard, you really got to...
You talked about it the day before, right?
Yeah, and then it goes to that slider and you look bad. So.
Man, he is. I don't know. I watched Nolan Ryan pitch, and I didn't. Maybe he threw that hard, but it didn't look. That guy last night looked like he was throwing so much harder than. I mean, Harvin threw 98. It wasn't like he. So it's only 3 miles an hour, but it just seemed like Chapman just looked like he threw faster than anybody else.
He's got that, everyone's like, oh, look how hard he throws. So he does come in, he's big, tall, long arm, and hides the ball well, and it comes out of his hand pretty good.
Do you kind of sense that this team, we're talking about Ike Davis, along with David Robinson, the local chairs of this charity event here today for the Players Association, do you kind of sense the team is turning the corner now, that with the better days are coming with all these young stud pitchers in?
It's easier to win games when, you only have to score 3.
Did you know Harvey? Have you seen Harvey enough to know he was going to be really good?
I knew he was going to be good. I didn't know he was going to be this good this fast. I knew he had the stuff. I mean, I'm looking, playing defense behind the stuff, but sometimes it takes a couple of years for a pitcher to be able to hit the spots and be consistent like he's done this year, which he's had a tremendous, amazing year. I mean, just watching it's been awesome.
And the team's played well, and it's funny because you might be the most popular guy in the room, so the guys love you on this team. I mean, they really do. And you're good friends with everybody, like Sat. Oh, I'm a good friend. You're good friends with everybody on this team. There's not a lot of backbiting on this team. It seems like a lot of friendly guys on this team.
Yeah, we have a good team. I mean, all the guys they care about each other. We try to breed an unselfish thing, kind of atmosphere in the locker room. Really being there and being a teammate, and because you're going to be together for how many days? We are 190 days in a row or games in a row. It's probably a good thing to at least try to get along and know who you're playing with.
Absolutely. We're talking about Ike Davis, who has obviously gone through a tough season here this year. Mets try to see if they, and it's important they have a little bit of a second half here, because it's important for Terry Collins, it's important for you, it's important for a lot of this is the kind of time you can see the trains maybe moving, and that this team, I think, next year has plans that they're going to be maybe better next year. You can kind of sense that they're ready to make their move.
For sure.
Bring a couple guys who can hit in, and maybe in the outfield, get it. Although Burns, the way he's been going is unbelievable, huh? He's been just tremendous.
He's having a very good year.
He sure is.
It was a nice addition this offseason getting him. Definitely gave us another power bat and a veteran for sure.
Do these young stud pitchers like Wheeler come in and fit in right away? I mean, when you see these young guys, I mean, you know, how do you treat these young pitchers when they arrive?
Mess around. I mean, yeah, try to make them uncomfortable so that they're comfortable in uncomfortable situations.
They're all different, though. Everyone's different, right? And Harvey's all business.
Harvey's all business, and you can't really fluster him.
He is confident, isn't he? I mean, he did a great job. I mean, first and second, I said last night, wow, this is going to be interesting. You're first and second, the world's watching, and they're standing in the box with the best hitter in the world. And you're saying, wow, this could be an interesting at bat. He did a nice job.
But he banged down, and he did a great job.
He really did. That was it. That was fun to watch. It really was last night. We're talking with Ike, of course, this charity event out here this week at the Players. And are you a golfer or not a golfer?
I golf in the office occasionally.
Oh, not the golf. This course. This course is killer. Yeah, but you know, even if you're good, this course is
this hard. Place would beat me up. I wouldn't even have fun because I would run out of balls the first three holes.
So, and you live out where there's a lot of golf courses too. Yeah. So you don't play that much?
I do. I play probably 10 times in off season, maybe.
Right.
I just started getting kind of into it.
Right.
You know, I used to hate it, and then now slowly I played with my dad a couple times in the off season, and it's an experience. It's good. Bonding and guy time, you know?
Can you get away from this thing at all, or does it follow you everywhere? I mean, does everyone stop you and say something to you? Gil Hodges was once in a slump in the World Series, the late Gil Hodges when he was in Brooklyn, and they were lighting candles for him. The little ladies were in Brooklyn lighting because he heads home for the World Series, and they're all there having, like, you know, doing the rosary for him and doing it. And, you know, you want, yours has become such a thing on a daily basis. I wonder if you can even go anywhere and hear anything except about it, right?
It's basically all that people talk about.
Right. Everyone's got a solution, right?
Yeah. Or a solution to get you out of state. But
yes.
I had people fly to Vegas and just to come yell at me.
Really? Why are you yelling at you in Vegas?
Oh, maybe. And they were, I think they were from New York. They'd just fly in and say their piece and take off again.
Have you noticed at home, like, one, it's always the same that you can kind of sense and hear? Can you kind of pick one person out?
No, they're all different.
They can be brutal too, right?
Yeah, they say some fun things.
Does it ever get to you?
It doesn't get you.
You feel like saying, I like to go say blah, 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 right?
Well, yeah, I mean, obviously they wouldn't say it to the
street
to me. Just don't do that as a human. But we are entertainers, and you know, honestly, they pay for
absolutely
to come in there and have fun too. So if they want to say I suck, then obviously they're more than welcome.
Oh, that's, you know, that's, but you know what? It's good. There's going to be a day you're going to get the smile about all this stuff.
Oh,
you know,
I mean, yeah, it doesn't, honestly, besides like not being able to get away from it, like.
Right.
You messed up, everyone knows you messed up, being a public figure, obviously, and that's the only bad thing about being a public figure.
It is.
Everyone knows when you messed up.
They do, and they don't let you forget about it. Exactly. Today, coming out here, it's a nice job for you. They sacrifice your days off because those are precious, obviously.
Here you?
Yeah, it's with me. Well, you gotta go back and tell you with the English, you dress for winter, right? I mean, you know, it's unbelievable, you know? But it is a good course because, you know, this area, really, and I grew up feet from the ocean. And I gotta tell you, we never take that stuff seriously because we've been warned like 100 times through the years. I mean, I remember as a teenager being such an idiot that we'd get an evacuation warning and we'd take our beach chairs and go down and sit on the beach and wait for the water to come. You know, as a 15-year-old, say, oh yeah, let's go, get our surfboards and wait, right? And nothing would happen. Well, finally, that storm that they talked about forever came and wiped everything out. And it was that perfect storm. You know, it wasn't just a hurricane. It was like that movie. It was like everything hit at one time, a nor'easter, this front, that. And they had like 12 feet of water in the street in some of those areas.
Yeah,
and it burnt out towns. And they got to rebuild everything in these towns. It's unbelievable. Well, I lived there to rebuild the entire boardwalk. They had to rebuild basically the whole city had to be rebuilt.
I know. I saw some pictures. I wasn't here for it, but I saw some pictures and it looked really...
It is. I mean, the Jersey Shore is cool, but some areas are completely like rearranged. Like the beach is like, was over here, it's not there anymore. I mean, they're going to the Army Corps of Engineers. I mean, this is like going to be 10 years, so you guys raising money today for that is, there's a lot of money still to be raised. There's a lot of people still need it, no question.
Yeah, people, you know, think that, you know, that this far away, everything's kind of settled up.
Yeah,
still a lot of work.
Oh, a lot. Good luck in the well, it's the second half, but we're pretty much well past the second half. But good luck to get things going. I want to be out there and see one of those, like, you know, three home run games. That'll be like the third trip around the base would be sweet.
Yeah.
Yeah? Then you can kind of gesture to the guys down the first baseline. Yeah? They'll all be up like this. You know, they'll be up. They'll look for autographs.
That's the best part, you know, like the Ike Davis.
I love you. I used to be with you.
You get used to it after a while.
Good to see you. Stay well. Like, don't get 20 hits in a row. Back after this. We're getting ready for the WFAN's Fantasy Phenom year number 4. How to do it? To get involved, to participate, you got to go to Moe's. That's right. You got to go to Odell's for your chance to win this year because they're hosting the gig. And this year, you get a chance to not only win a program and become an FAN talk show host, but you get to drive around in a new Hyundai from Lester Glen Hyundai, Route 37, Thomas River, New Jersey. So you get a car and a job. How about that? Car and a job. Now, 3 qualifying rounds taking place, 100 contestants at each of the following Modell's locations. Thursday, July 25th at Columbus Avenue in Manhattan. Saturday, July 27th at Edgewater, New Jersey. Tuesday, July 30th, in Plainview, Long Island. You can come solo, come as a pair, get to the shows. You got it. You got to show everybody what you have, all the rules and full details. And if you make it to the final 5, you will join me down at the Bar A show, and you get a chance there to square up against your contemporaries, and you get a chance to maybe be this year's Fantasy Phenom for year number 4. It's brought to you by Modell's. You got to go to Moe's. And, of course, the fan.
It doesn't take long to save money with GEICO. Just 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on your car insurance. And who wouldn't spend 15 minutes to save hundreds? Well, I mean, besides people who are so rich they drive helicopters to work. Why not call GEICO today?
Right now, during the Volvo Summer Sales event, pay nothing for 3 months when you buy or lease any 2013 Volvo. Visit volvocars.com/US for more details.
Report software piracy to BSA, the Software Alliance, and you may be eligible for a cash reward. Confidential reports are also accepted. Report piracy today. C.org. Be part of the solution and report software piracy. That's nopiracy.org.
Are you still smoking tobacco? Don't strike out. Choose the most trusted brand in premium electronic cigarettes. Logic. No tar, secondhand smoke. Extra thick paper that completely satisfies. Win every time with Logic Premium Electronic Cigarettes.
15 minutes can save you 15% or more on car insurance. Visit us at geico.com or call 1-800-947-AUTO.
Hi, good evening. It's 6:20. I'm Chris Lopresti. The return of Alex Rodriguez to the Yankee lineup sounds inevitable. A-Rod's rehab assignment is drawing to a close. He'll join AAA Scranton for their game tomorrow night. And told our own Mike Francesa this afternoon he'll meet with the Yankees in Arlington for Monday's series opener against the Rangers. Expects to be in the lineup at that point. Among other things, Rodriguez said he feels good, expects to make an impact on the team along with other players returning from injury. Also said he hasn't made any deals with Major League Baseball regarding potential suspension stemming from the Biogenesis investigation. You can hear a replay of the full A-Rod interview here on The Fan coming up at the top of the hour. Meanwhile, the Yankees continue to enjoy the All-Star break. They're back in action Friday when they open a 3-game series against the Red Sox at Fenway Park. The Mets get set for a 7-game homestand that includes 3 against the Phillies this weekend at Citi Field. Also, former Giants kicker Lawrence Tynes landing a deal with the Bucks today after the team announced Connor Barth has been lost for the upcoming season. He tore his Achilles tendon playing in a charity basketball game last week. This report brought to you by Nissan Certified Pre-Owned Vehicles, which come with a factory-backed 7-year, 100,000-mile limited warranty and complimentary Carfax Vehicle History Report. Visit NissanUSA.com today for details. And with reports every 20 minutes, Chris Lopresti, WFAN 2020 Sports.
Listen to the Mets and Phillies Friday night at 7:10 with Mets Extra at 6:30 as baseball returns to Citi Field following the All-Star break. Hi, I'm Howie Rose. Join me along with Josh Lewin for all the play-by-play right after Mike's on, exclusively on The Fan, Sports Radio 66 and 101.9 FM, WFAN, WFAN FM, New York.
Approaching 6:22 on this Wednesday evening, we check traffic and transit. The STS Tyron Auto Fan Highway Patrol with Adrian Watts.
Thank you, Chris. In Rutherford, New Jersey, southbound Route 17 is closed between Union Avenue and Highland Cross with a police investigation. Delays back to Route 46. Go with the Parkway if you can. Eastbound Bell Parkway loaded. Cross the avenue to Rockaway Parkway where an accident blocks 2 lanes. Eastbound Staten Island Expressway jam 440 to Slauson with a car fire. Lincoln Tunnel 50 minutes in. The Holland 15 minutes out. Long Island Railroad suspended westbound Jamaica to Penn. No eastbound service to Far Rockaway and Hempstead out of Penn Station. Take the 2 or 3 subways to Atlantic.